Now tracking a dramatic increase in the number of Omicron subvariants causing COVID-19 infections in the U.S. And here to answer questions is Dr. Daniel Karitskis, Chief of Infectious Diseases at the Brigham. Dr. Karitskis, thanks for joining us.
Happy to be here, Erica and Ben.
All right, Dr. Karitskis, it seems almost quaint that we used to worry about, you know, maybe two or three subvariants. Well, health officials now say there are at least a dozen currently circulating in the U.S. Do you think that number could climb even higher? And does it really matter since they're all in some way related to Omicron?
Yeah, we really have an alphabet soup of Omicron subvariants right now. I think the most important thing is that even though we continue to see this population diversify, we're not seeing an increased number of cases being reported. There was a slight uptick in the amount of SARS-CoV-2 in the sewage, but it's not showing up in numbers of cases, and that's the important thing. So we shouldn't worry so much about how many variants are there as long as they're not causing more problems.
Okay, so let's get to some questions from viewers as well. This one comes from Lynn, who writes, I received my bivalent booster as soon as it became available in early September. What does it mean in terms of protection? Does it wane? Can I get another booster when it does?
We honestly don't know yet because there's not been long enough follow-up. It's almost certain that some of the protection will wane just as it has with the other boosters, so that after several weeks, you may not be protected against infection, but you will have long-lasting protection against severe disease, needing to be hospitalized or worse. And that's the most important thing. We'll be getting guidance down the road from the CDC about when people should get another bivalent booster.
All right, so here's another one. This one's from Andy. He says, should people who are immunocompromised get two shots of the new booster? What say you, Dr.
No. Sorry, no, not at the moment. Currently, the only recommendation is that after people have finished their primary series, which for an immunocompromised individual would mean after getting three of the original shots, then at least two months later, they can get the bivalent booster. But there's no recommendation currently for such individuals to get additional bivalent boosters. There are some particularly different situations where people just start on an immunosuppressing regimen. They should talk to their healthcare provider about those unique situations, but otherwise, no, just one bivalent booster, even for immunocompromised people.
Okay, Dr. Karitskis, thanks as always for being with us.
You're very welcome.
Thank you.